Lichess. 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 Lichess.
You don't hear me. Can you hear me now? You can. Can you hear me now? I guess you can. The music is hot. Yeah, can you hear me now? Okay, you can. I don't know. Mic is not working. No? No, you hear me now. Oh, yeah. And now you can hear me. Now you can hear me again. Okay, cool, cool, cool. Because, yeah, I have to figure that out after the stream. Mic is on. you can hear me. That's great. Sound quality is poor. Is it still... Okay, is it still bad? Yes, I'm static. No, I have not changed the mic. However, for some reason, my computer doesn't find it as an option. So let me try to now it's
work. Yeah, now it's working. Yes, okay, this is the good mic. Hopefully this one will work. Now you can hear me well. Should be. This microphone is good. Here it is. Yay, we won. We already won. We have not started, but we already won. How are you doing, guys? Okay, first of all, welcome to the Blitz titled arena in December, and I'm just gonna put on the first game that I see right now. Of course, we're gonna follow some strong masters, grandmasters in the future, but first I would like to say hello to the chat, hello to everybody that's watching. We're gonna put some music as well, just to have a good mood. Some blue for the start. So, should be good now. I have been okay today. Today I took a long rest and I was cleaning my room. I know it doesn't look clean, but I'm on my way to cleaning it. This is a chess only channel? No, it's also programming channel, if I'm correct. Naroditsky is playing again. Yes, I saw Rebecca Harris on the list. Cool, guys, you can hear me. YouTube chat, can you hear me as well? Perfect, perfect. That's great. Okay, let's then start with... Okay, first of all, some players already berserking and have 6 points, which is normal. We just have to find their 369 players exactly. By the way, guys, whoever is titled in the chat can join the arena. If you're not titled, sadly you cannot play, but there was... a warm-up before, where I think also non-titled players can play. Stream is good, perfect. I thought if we could do that drawing game afterwards. Einstein, yeah, not on Lichess channel. But maybe on Chiquitas, just I don't think today, because this stream is gonna last 3 hours. So be prepared. Okay, let's check Rebecca Harris. Okay, so Rebecca Harris is Naroditsky. He's, as everybody knows, one of the strongest players out there. I will just fix the layout slightly because I see something here. Okay, here we go. Yes, perfect. I changed the layout, by the way. Hope you like it. I took Lichess layout for Lichess streams. Magnus will join later. Yeah, totally. You know, if Magnus joins today's stream, you know, then the stream is just gonna be over. I will be so surprised. Hello. Team A is playing. Team A is not playing because he's not titled. Yes, that's good. Okay, what layout? Okay, let's check this game right now. Naroditsky, as I said, he's a strong grandmaster under name Rebecca Harris, which, you know, I applaud his choice of nickname. And he sacrificed his bishop? Okay, so I think they both berserked. I don't know if I can confirm that, but he's playing a strong grandmaster Rechmano, so I would say that he did not berserk. And he sacrificed... Why did he sacrifice a bishop? Was that necessary? Was that really necessary? I guess he thought that was good compensation for some reason. Even though when this knight comes to action, I would not be happy. Ah, because the rook was trapped. Ah, that's true. So basically, Black's plan here was knight c8 and the rook would be trapped. That's true, but his other choice would be to sack the rook and take the... I guess he made the right decision. Yeah, I guess he made the right decision. Also, time is ticking down and Rachmaninoff had 17 seconds, but Rebecca Harris resigned because he tried the dirty trick. Rook d1, and of course Rachmaninoff took it and he resigned, which is, you know, okay. But yeah, that was a good point. The rook was indeed trapped on b6. Good point. Okay. Who else should we check? Guys, give me some suggestions in the chat if there is a player like Never Enough. I don't know who he is, but I like his name. Let's check who it is. Boris Gracho. I like his name. He's Grandmaster, you know, 29. People hey. Yeah. And what is this endgame? In fact, we have Black's a pawn up, but now not. Yes, still Black's a pawn up, but this could be a good pass pawn, but also this could be a pass pawn. Yeah, this should just be a draw now. But 9 seconds against 1 minute and 30. Ooh, Never Enough. We'll probably lose this game due to time. Due to poor time management. However, no, it's been a draw, okay. He was a bit lucky because Black can actually not move the king further away from here. For example, after this, the knight would fall. But I think that was not a good decision from Black because 5 seconds, he should have sacrificed the knight here and let him just here. Let him, you know, play some moves, put the king here and here. I don't think he would have made it in 5 seconds. Is Penguin playing? Yeah, the tournament lasts 3 hours, yes. I'm gonna be live for 3 hours! Also with the H-pawn, true. Let's look at Michael. Who is Michael, by the way? Mikola Bortnik! So he's... He's the brother of the famous Alexander Bortnik, who wins all the arenas on literally every website he plays on. So Michael is his brother, international master. Yeah, one rating difference, yeah. How are the other chickadees doing? I don't know Einsteini. I have slight contact to them, but not much. Yeah, Mikhail Bortnik. But I will. I have to still ask them about streaming, so we will be in contact. The other Bortnik is a great blitz player too. Yeah, Bortnik Alexander is one of the greatest blitz players, at least if not online, also offline. And he was also, when I was world champion under 16, he was the world champion under 18 in South Africa. So we were both the world champions at the same time. That's how I knew him. Ooh, that was a blunder by White, and Michael won. Good game, good tricks. He has good tricks as well. Onishchuk is playing. Oh no, he already won. Onishchuk already won. So currently Manafa Vugar is leading. He's only FIDE Master, but has lost first game and then won all the other games. Okay, let's go check who else. Who else? Rahmanov is still here. Chess Today. Heard of them. Never Enough. Oh. Thank you. Knight King, right? Okay, let's check Zhigalko. You know, Zhigalko is also streaming, by the way, so you can definitely check out his stream as well. I'm not sure if he's streaming in Russian. I assume yes. But I don't know. I assume he's streaming in Russian. He's from Belarus. Okay, so he's playing very standard, typical position. Like, you know, classical positions that are known for a long time. And I would have to say that I would prefer white. Like, I would play just knight g5 here. h7 pawn would be... then you would have to play h6, and then maybe some knight h7 tricks. I'm not sure. I like the open f file. I like white position. My Russian doesn't cut it. Yeah. Well, both brothers have won title arena. Ah. Okay. Thank you, Einstein. Yeah, that it's very hard. I have to say it's very hard. That's why I'm always tired. But you know, these things are very fun for me because I get to talk with you guys, and also I get to watch chess and commentate some good games. And actually I prefer that than playing, because when you play you lose and then you feel sad and bad and embarrassed. And if you just commentate, you know, here, I would just take sacrifice, you know, even though this probably is... What is this? Is this lost? I wouldn't even say that's lost. That's actually Oleg playing extremely well, and I feel Zhigalko is not feeling comfortable in this position. Takes this, goes back. And then what's the plan? D5. D5 could be the plan, because then you take and... Ooh, he takes directly? What? Ah! Honestly, I don't think that was the most practical thing. I think D5 was just better, because after this, his plan, I guess, is to go rook F1. But then you just take and you have two rooks. Or you don't even have to take. You can take here and then after... No, you have to take. Okay. So you take and then you take. And what's wrong with this position? Honestly, I don't think there's anything wrong with this position at all. Even if you take with this, just go here then. Am I missing something? So that's why I think in this position the more practical move is to go d5. And because this is a huge threat, I guess. Or just taking with the rook and then with the bishop. But okay. No, yeah. Okay, he went for rook e7. But I don't think black now should be scared. We will look at Knight King, for sure we will. We will. I just am really interested in this game right now, and after this game we'll definitely look at Knight King, for sure. Also we'll check what YouTube chat says. YouTube chat is not as active. Shout out from Philippines. Hello from Slovenia. Okay, so YouTube chat is not as active as Twitch chat, you know, which is cool, which is pretty cool. I am well. How about you guys? Okay. Here we go. My room looks comfortable, thank you. That's why I decided to decorate it in comfortable way. So it's pretty comfortable. Okay, so what happened here? So queen went back. Queen went back. Black has 14 seconds, but like I said, black should not be scared of anything, even maybe should be scared now. He definitely wants to block this. Oh no, bishop here was a strong move. But Jigalko didn't have time to play it. Bishop here was a strong move to get rid of this bishop. Yeah, now we get a piece. Well, 4 seconds is not enough. 4 seconds is not enough to hold this game for Jigalko, definitely. Hugs. I'm well. Chesweet, but how are you? Yeah, like I said, this was definitely not enough time for Jigalko and he had to resign. Let's look at Knight King. I will search because I just don't. Knight King. Where are you? Well, where is he? Ah, here we go. Well, here we go. Okay, he just started the game. Did Laura win title arena on Lichess? No, never. Never. No German players? Oof. Maybe they're busy. but it's fine, guys. Like I said, if you're titled or and tilted at the same time, you know, you can play the titled arena. You can join the arena, but if you're not titled, you just watch this stream and we will watch the best players in the world fight it out in the Blitz titled arena of December. This is the tempo is 3 minutes plus 0 seconds, so that's why it's extra entertaining because there's no added time. It lasts 3 hours, so guys, we're gonna be here for a long time. You can make yourself some tea or hot cocoa. I made myself hot cocoa. And just enjoy the cozy stream. There are for sure a few. Yeah, I was thinking the same. Maybe some players just don't have the flag under. Okay, by the way, what's this game? Black has 2 bishops. The pawn structure is very weird, however, material is equal. So, I don't like this pawn, but also this pawn is not that great. How would you play king here? Okay, but how does black progress? I don't know how does black progress. I think also knight king has much less time, more than a minute. I guess he berserked for this game while white didn't, so this is gonna not gonna be easy to win because Bortnik with is this Bortnik account? Yeah, Bortnik is very good in tactical positions and tricks, and when there's so like little pieces on the board, it's very hard to make tricks. In fact, this is one trick white cannot take because he would lose a rook to this check. You know, Luka Doncic, I don't know him personally, however I had a schoolmate who trained with Luka Doncic, but yeah. I don't know him personally. With Knight King. Knight King is Alexander Bortnik. I'm sure that whoever is watching these arenas or is participating in these arenas on chess.com or only chess, you have heard of Alexander Bortnik, right? Right? Otherwise, he's a strong Ukrainian, originally Ukrainian player. He's amazing Blitz player, one of the best Blitz players in the world, especially in online chess. He won the last Blitz title arena, okay. So yeah, I think he's a professional chess player as well, so he participates in these arenas very, very often. Especially due to very nice prizes, which I really, really support that online chess is still living on even though COVID hopefully will soon end. And that's good. Yeah, chess, cool. That's good. Ah, he found German players. Interesting. Okay, so what is this game? Okay, we stopped talking about the game, we started talking about fun facts. I think black is winning. I think he should have taken first, but okay, doesn't really matter that much, especially because the bishop has no problem protecting. 14 seconds though. 14 seconds. 14 seconds only. This is winning, but 14 seconds only. Opa! Here we go. And now we take. Yeah. Look, he even pre-moved bishop f8. He knew he would queen. He will win with 4 seconds. I know he will win with 4 seconds. Here we go. He won 4 seconds. Easily done for Bortnik. He didn't have to think that hard to win this game. GG. Who else should we look at? Who else do you want? So we have Night King, we have Rebecca Harris. Who else could we? He's number 2 right now, okay. Out of 410 players. A lot of players did join. Batuhan Ozen, I feel like I know him. Oh, Rebecca Harris is back in the game. On 24th spot? Wait, I lost him. I lost Rebecca Harris. Here we go. He's playing Batuhan Ozen exactly, so. Let's check. This is a wild game. Wait, what happened here? This was the Sicilian, okay. So I guess this is an opening one way or the other, but giving the f7 pawn is never amazing. And given the time that Batuhan has 1 minute and 30 seconds, he is in trouble. He is indeed in trouble. Okay, so I'm just trying to... Here we go. Scroll until you find someone below 1000. You think that's possible? Let's go till the end. Okay, look, there's a 1500. 1800. Okay, we found some, but otherwise I think that's mostly it. Otherwise everybody's above 2300. Yeah, okay. Okay, I think Rebecca Harris is just winning this game, and Rebecca Harris is gonna be back in the leader spot very, very soon. Very soon, I guess. Because this is already winning, he resigned, Tia Black resigned, he said, okay, I have enough. Which is correct way to do, and now Rebecca Harris is on number 10 spot, just going up and up. Smoking Samra, who is that? I like the name. Samra, okay. Smoking Samra, let's watch Smoking Samra. Ah, okay. He's playing exactly against Rebecca Harris. What a coincidence. Why am I not playing? Because I'm commentating. I could be playing, but I would be tilting, and you definitely don't want me to tilt on stream, because you're gonna feel very bad for me. You're gonna be like, please stop the stream, it's okay. Yeah, I get very emotional sometimes, especially when I lose too much. And definitely I like playing in these tournaments, but on stream I'm always stressed about it for some reason. WCMs are the lowest rated players, you think? It's also the lowest category where you can still be titled. So this is the reason why they're the lowest rated. Yes, Rebecca Harris is Naroditsky. Yes, Mikhail Bortnik with a higher rating than his brother. What? Whoa! And he's international master as well. Yeah, definitely. Actually, I would have won easily. Speaks, yeah. Definitely, you know, I would just be crushing everybody and all the grandmasters would be crying. So, you know, I wanted to give them some peace for December, because otherwise, you know, it would be funny if Magnus participated. Yeah, definitely. That would just be a troll against Jan. That would be such a troll, like, you know, playing World Championship and playing the title arenas. That would be great, fine. A W, I am stronger than I am. No, Duly. I am is the second strongest title in chess. I am is above WGM. I am is above Woman Grandmaster title. So I am is the second strongest title in chess, and GM is the strongest title in chess. Just for your information. Also, White is doing quite well. Especially because Rook is coming somewhere here, and White has so much more space than Black. So Rebecca Harris not feeling that great, not feeling that great. Yeah, Nepo wouldn't believe it. Yeah. If Magnus would play, it would be the funniest thing ever. Is Tang playing though? Is Penguin playing? I have not seen him yet, but we'll definitely check. More letters not equal to more strength. I have been bamboozled. Yes. International Master sounds cooler than Grandmaster? No, it doesn't. No. You're the only one having connection issues. Guys, is it lagging? Is the stream lagging for you? It should not be lagging. I have 60 frames per second. I guess that should be enough. Also, my internet connection is very stable. Okay. Thank you, Fast Strike. So this is how the titles work. This is how the titles work. So first Grandmaster, then International Master, then Woman Grandmaster, then FIDE Master, then Woman International Master, which is equal to Candidate Master, is stronger than Woman FIDE Master and is stronger to Woman Candidate Master. I am a Lichess commentator too, Tommy. Stream is good. Okay, let's go check back to the game. Has Naroditsky improved his position? I guess yes, because he's winning this pawn, right? At least for now. For now, I guess the reason is just for now, because even king coming here is not enough for Black. Yeah, that's why he has to do something with the rook here. Rook here, I guess. Okay. Let's just see what they're gonna do. I don't know what's planned of Rebecca Harris. King g6 is logical. Okay, king g2 is fine. What's the plan? Oh no, rook cannot go here, so that's good. Rook is just here. Basically, this is the best square it can be. Which is three more. Thank you, Johnny. We'll try. Can men be a WGM? No. They're only women titles. Yeah, this is the thing. It's very confusing for a lot of people, and I was thinking to make a YouTube video about the chess titles and the reason behind it. But I'm not sure if actually it would be helpful to anyone. Oh, there's only one video quality option. I guess this is Lichess. Are we verified on Twitch? Because if we're not verified, so if we're not partnered on Twitch, then we cannot change the video option. This is how it works. If you're verified on Twitch, you can change the video quality. Viewers can change it. If you are verified, so if you're partnered, you can. If you're not, as I think we are not. So we are not partnered, that means that nobody can change the video quality, and this is why it's lagging. Yeah, sorry about that, sorry. Wait, is game finished? Oh, Rebecca Harris resigned? Okay, so... No, it was a draw. Okay, it was a draw. Cool. Okay, it was a draw. I was scared he resigned. I was like, why? Because actually White cannot take it because King f6 and now the bishop is trapped. And if white wants to save it, it's with h4. And then, of course, should be equal. Okay, GG. So we're checking. Bortnik, where is Bortnik? Oh, Michael leading. So Bortnik's brother leading. Let's watch his game. I feel like black is in trouble. King is on f8. And has to come to g7. However, after king g7, knight f5, and black is losing the queen, so king cannot even go to g7, where it can be safe. Yeah, and Russian enemies around. I am true. I knew Naroditsky can speak Russian. I think he... I don't know why exactly, but I heard him speak Russian, I think. I think I heard him. Not sure though. Chess is partner and Lichess isn't. I think it's our choice though. I think we could be partner if we wanted to, but we choose not to be. I think that's the reason. Thank you, Nestjes. Thank you. So National Master is similar to CM is Candidate Master, yeah. So National Master titles are actually not official FIDE titles, if I'm correct. But I'm not sure. It's only in America, okay. Okay, so what happened here? Whoa. This is becoming a queen, I feel like. This is just crushing. I think white is just winning. Even if he took here, that would be winning. Okay, sorry, it was a check, so he could not take here, yeah. So first protect the check, and now take here, yes. Yes. And now white can also just go here and take the rook. And it's easy GG. So Michael actually lost against Chess today. Wow, Chess today winning. So this changes the standings. In fact, now Michael is not on fire anymore. However, Vugar is. Let's go back to Bortnik's game. Bortnik's game are always entertaining. 7 seconds. Well, this doesn't look comfortable for 6 seconds. I feel like Bortnik is losing this game. 6 seconds, I feel like he's losing the game. Yeah. Yes, he's losing the game. 2 seconds. Oh god. Look at that! Oh my god, look at that. He did lose the game, but he was very fast. Who will win World Championship? Well, so far Magnus is looking pretty good. What do you guys think? Did I learn Russian? No, I did not learn Russian. I learned German in school. However, I always wanted to learn Russian for some unknown reason to life. Let's go back to watching Michael. He's playing FIDE Master. FIDE Master is being very high right now for such a strong field. You can actually subscribe to this channel, so you must be partnered, right? No, Lutik. On Twitch you can be affiliate or partner. If you're affiliate, you can, your viewers can still subscribe, but you're not a partner, so you don't have some things that partners do have. And then when you reach certain viewership and certain goals that make you be partner, or then you apply for partnership and then Twitch has to accept you to be a partner, and then you're a partner. You're supposed to have, when you're a partner, you're supposed to have some more things, I don't know, but actually, like, Chiquitas are partners, and I have to say there's no difference between being affiliate and a partner, so it's basically not a big deal. Thank you, Johnny, thank you. I know Russian accent, but I don't know Russian. I am a grandmaster in mimicry, exactly. Then why some channels don't have this subscription option? Because they're not affiliate, Kushal. If you're not affiliate, then... this looks like a crushing attack for white. If you're not an affiliate... Michael, another loss. What I wanted to say, if you're not an affiliate, you just have the follow button and not the subscribe button. Better to donate directly to Lichess. Yes, I actually, you know, I was actually donating for 1 month, and I think I'm gonna do it for December because it's the holiday season and they deserve it. Yeah, Lichess is great. I mean, I can't believe that there are no ads. You don't have to pay for anything. It's literally all free. It's crazy. So yeah, if you want to support Lichess, you can definitely donate. You can also subscribe. You can also follow. Everything's, you know, little details in life are important as well. Bortnik again. Okay, so he's berserking all game. So Bortnik just wants to win, so he's gonna berserk till the end of the life, and he just lost a piece. Yeah, affiliates also need 3 average viewers, but Self-Destroyer, if I guess you know that, but you also have to apply to be affiliate, I think. Yeah, you have to. So if you don't apply, you don't have to be affiliate as well. For example, yeah. How do such free websites earn money, especially in the beginning? I don't know. I think it's not about earning money, it's about having a lot of volunteers that want to help to build huge chess community. So these people are actually not getting paid, especially at the beginning, and then when everything works and a lot of people play, then sponsors, I guess, are investing in such beautiful websites. I'm not sure how this works exactly, but I just know there are a lot of volunteers. So who else should we watch? Where is Rebecca Harris? Where is Rebecca Harris? Where is Rebecca Harris? Ah, here we go. Here we go. Okay, I guess he's gonna play another game soon. None of it's an idea. Did Lichess ban Kibi extension? I don't know. I don't know. Heisenberg, okay, who are watching? Chess Today, I guess, is on fire, I would say. Slightly on fire. Ah, yeah, Dropstone berserked and Chess Today didn't. Who's Dropstone? David Paravian, he's a strong player. And who's Chess Today? Zidipo. Okay. I can comment it in Russian accent if you want some games. Also in French accent. Ooh, this looks terrible. This looks terrible. Ay, 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 what is this? This white has a huge, huge, huge attack here. No, they did not, unfortunately. I don't know what is Kibi extension, what is it? Yes, French? Yeah, that. Okay, maybe I could try. As a pawn, yeah. As a pawn. As a pawn took the front. The knight on g6, huh? No, okay, so let me check the YouTube a bit. Where's Time? Time is in his room playing games. Where is Magnus Carlsen on Lichess? Yeah, he's playing the World Championship, so I guess he's not here. How's Lara and the cat? I'm boring, I'm sorry. You want me to be more entertaining? I'm here to commentate chess games, aren't I? The French accent was quite good, okay. Okay, so I'm gonna continue commentating the French accent and knight f6, ooh la 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 la, c'est pas bien. Now in king and check, and king has to move f7 and then ooh, taking. Okay. Knight d5 was good, but okay, this sacrifice, oof. If black takes bishop f6 and now the queen is hanging, and I don't think that would be a good thing to play, so black just resigned, and now we're going to to go back and follow another game. Let's follow the game of Chess King again. He has to win. He's a good player, but he played not so good today. Le baguette z4, exactly. Russian accent more entertaining. Okay, come on. Come on, be nice to me. I'm trying my best. Okay, I have to learn British accent at some point. I'm very bad. Okay, Borting is just not playing so good today. He's berserking all games and then losing all games, so I think he's on tilt and should listen to the haters. No, it's fine. I'm just being who I am, you know. If I'm not enough entertaining for you, it's okay. It's okay. I'm getting used to streaming again. Okay, so he resigned. Okay, let's go back. Who are we watching, guys? Please give me a suggestion who to watch. Listen, I know there's a lot of strong players playing today. I would just like to know whose games you want to follow, except Michael, Night King, so Bortnik brothers, Rebecca Harris. So we have three people who to follow. Who else could we follow? What about Slovenian accent? I don't know. I speak English in Slovenian accent. I just don't know how else to speak Italian accent. Oof. Could I do? I don't think. Okay, I could try doing Italian accent. I can do Italian accent in Slovenian. I cannot do it. I don't know if I can do it in English though. So cool. Okay, let's watch Magnus. I don't think Magnus is playing here. What's his name? I don't even know. I don't even know his username on Lichess. Chess today, we can watch Chess today. Mud Pro won all his games. Okay, let's watch Mud Pro. Who is he? I don't know. I will try working mainly. Okay, I will try working on my Italian accent in between. Ah, he's Doctor. Okay, Doctor Nickenstein. Okay. I don't think he's playing. Yeah, he's not playing today. He's not playing today. Definitely shouldn't. Yeah, he's not playing, yeah, definitely. Okay, he's a strong iron from Vietnam. I see. And also he's winning, yeah, he sacrificed the piece. This is a beautiful sacrifice, because e4 followed by e5 wins the piece back. But also, this wins an exchange. What is this, however? King is weak, but can I just go rook c8? I can. F6, yeah. What now? Okay, now let's say we take. I guess we take here, and then this is a huge threat. Okay, makes sense. Why would you? You cannot take because the rook is hanging. Okay, black is winning this game. So Matt Pro won all his games until I started watching. I'm sorry. I guess I would still go queen f3 try and then take on f6, but I apologize. Exactly, pass strike, yeah. Yeah, it would be sick if Magnus played online, really. True. Yeah. It's funny how Dania is Rebecca when he's not streaming. Yeah, that's definitely funny. Maybe he's playing online chess. Yeah. I think, guys, he was playing before the World Championship. He was playing Penguin, I think. And he adopted him and then he started playing World Championship. Oh, I'm sorry for the arrows. Yeah, this is just lost for white, so we can just stay. And watch. My family is downstairs and they're currently watching the fighting battles. So, UFC, I think. They're watching the UFC battle fights, the fights. So I'm just hearing them screaming from downstairs. And I'm here commentating chess. So queen e6 just happened. And when is white resigning? I don't know. But I feel like king is much safer. And oh, h4 is coming. So king will not now be safe on this diagonal. So maybe this is not so easily actually. But okay, now f4 pawn is hanging. And this is just game over, white should resign. So they want to be as loud as the match. They want to be louder. And I'm here. Yeah, and I'm gonna be here commenting the chess. Let me try to commentate the chess as entertaining as commentating the sport. next game, I'm gonna try, okay? I'm gonna try my best. And then the second game, I'm gonna commentate in Russian accent, okay? So it's gonna be entertaining. Okay, let's pick the game, let's pick Rebecca Harris if we can. Where is Rebecca though? Okay, so this position, how can we evaluate it? So black has a pawn up and he has a bishop against a knight in a huge endgame. Rebecca Harris has to win to get back into the top 10, and if he wins or she wins, we can expect a huge return from Rebecca. And okay, the pawn on a5 could be a potential queen. That's why sacrifices the knight and now has two pawns and just has to exchange one for this pawn, and then it's gonna be a draw. Hard draw, but it's gonna be a draw. However, 15 seconds for Papasi against Rebecca, so this is not enough time to hold a draw in rook with bishop against the rook. However, it is theoretical draw. Let's see how Papasi will try to hold on to this game, and maybe we can expect a draw at the end. No, the pawn hanged, and now 6 seconds. Let's see if we can find the win. Oh, and checkmate in the next move. Papasi blundered the checkmate and game is over. Rebecca Harris is back in the game. Yeah, PogChamps is commentating like mad sport. Yeah, I guess. So I don't know how people do it, because actually I'm really out of breath. When I speak very fast, it's like a sport to me. I'm really out of breath. And yeah, it's game over. So Rebecca Harris won. Let's go watch. You know what? Yeah, let's just watch the best players. Who else? We didn't see Dropstone today. Dropstone is number one, and we still have not watched his game. And be like XQC. Yeah, I cannot be like XQC. It's not what I do. Who is Rebecca Harris that Dania named his account after? Rebecca Harris is a politician. Yeah. Yeah, I gotta keep drinking water while I stream, otherwise I can just not talk that much. I don't know how is it for you guys, but it's very hard to talk fast for me. That's why I'm being very calm, trying to be very calm. But okay, now when we're here, let's commentate in Russian accent. So rook d6, okay, knight b7, rook under attack. So check, rook on 7 rank is a very good rook. Okay, now this is not winning any material. Or is it? Oh, maybe it's winning. But how is it winning is the question. Ah, it's winning. How is it winning? Okay, now this checkmate threat, but it doesn't look... Okay! What a beautiful combination by Dropstone. Look at this. Rook h1 takes in g4 checkmate. I thought this was a blunder. I thought, okay, this terrible pre-move. But takes an OG4 and this checkmate, what a surprise! Can you do impersonations? is Elval Galaga playing the arena? Who is he? What's his username? I've never heard of her in your English. Who's the vice president of Biden right now? Laura on planet Ivanchuk, yes! I'm so on planet Ivanchuk, yes. That's so me right now. Kamala Harris, yeah, I think, yeah, Kamala Harris, yeah. I know it's not Rebecca Harris, but I think I'm sure he named himself after politician. Maybe he mixed two politicians or something like that. I don't remember. But I did hear the story that he named himself after politician. Not sure though. So who else should we follow? Mud Pro we followed. Smurf. chess today. Heisenberg. Let's follow Heisenberg. I like his name. The Heisenberg principle, as we use it. Is that one that is a character? Oh, it's a character in TV show? Really? Okay, maybe I was wrong. Okay, we came at the end exactly, because g6 is just checkmate in the next move, so Heisenberg won the game. Oh my god, look at this. I don't know if you can see it. You guys cannot see it, but let me tell you. Knight King. He started a very shaky way, you know. Lost, won two games. And right now he has very bad score. He's just berserking too much. It's not his day, but Michael, it could be Michael's day today. Knight King, never enough. Dimitri, Last Gladiator. Should we follow Last Gladiator? Who is Last Gladiator? Ah, okay, I know him. He's a very young, talented grandmaster from Azerbaijan. Okay. Heisenberg is a strong young French player? Really? That's good. Ah, okay. But it wrote he was Turkish. He was playing under Turkish flag. So maybe it was not the French player. Maybe it's just a nickname. Ah, from Breaking Bad series. Okay. I didn't know. Okay, sorry. Nihal sharing games. Is Nihal playing? I don't think Nihal is playing. But if Nihal is playing, guys, please tell me his username. Ah, it's a TV character. No, his former girlfriend. Heisenberg is a Turkish player. Okay, yeah, I thought so. Okay, thank you for telling me. Okay, so this game, Last Gladiator, is now wide, but I feel like this pawn, is it strong? It's not coming to b7. I really like black pawns. I really like these black pawns. Honestly, I prefer black right now. Knight King might finally win a game. I don't know how. I feel like bishop h6 was maybe more practical to go d2. Okay. Oh, no. This is now just lost. This is now just lost for white. Okay, Knight King will definitely win this game, and they both berserk, so it's enough. Okay. I never watched Breaking Bad. No. University student. Okay, good. He's playing very well this arena. Heisenberg is currently on fifth place, which is a great score. However, there is still 2 hours to go. That's a lot of time. You should be texting very fun. Okay, should definitely watch Breaking Bad. I don't want to watch Breaking Bad just because I know there's so many episodes and seasons to watch. And I just don't want to spend so much time, you know. So let's follow chess today now. Chess today has 11 seconds against 48 seconds of black, which is not so amazing, but has an exchange up. And I'm just trying to figure out what's gonna happen here. I don't think 9 seconds is enough to win this game with white pieces. In fact, I feel like this is gonna end very bad for white. Okay, f7 is hanging, but that doesn't really matter. 4 seconds. Chess today might not win against National Master. See, that's what's so surprising to me. Player is National Master, which is how much? 2000 rated player, something like that. 22 rated player. Something like that, and they play for 2700 on Lichess. That's just crazy. He's 2700 and he's 22 on FIDE. That's crazy. The Americans? Okay. I won't regret it, just 6 seasons. Okay, guys, if you tell me to watch it, I will watch it, sure. Sure, I will. Okay. If you tell me, I will. So Smurf on 5th place now. Smurf won all of his last 7 games, is that correct? No, no, more than 7. He won, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 games. He won 9 games in a row, Smurf. Wow, crazy, crazy, crazy. So Dropstone still in the first place, but leading with a great difference from the second place. In fact, just let me tell you, first place has 59 points, second place 45 points. Huge advantage for Dropstone, and if he keeps the advantage, he's the winner for sure of today's titled arena. He's white now, so he should not lose. Okay, this could be played. Is this a draw? No. Okay, so Rebecca Harris won. Rebecca Harris finally won against the strong player. Wait, what? Yeah, black is victorious. Okay. Rebecca Harris finally won and Dropstone lost. He lost the fire. He won all of the games. In fact, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I don't know, I cannot even count, more than 13 games in a row. And now he lost, finally. And Rebecca Harris now in 5th place. And he's already playing the next game against Night King. Let's follow this game. Yeah, it's massive, but now he finally lost. Crazy. Okay. Feeder rating is classical rating, but here this blitz rating. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes, Mikhail Tal, I agree. I know that. But you know, it's not also just during the pandemic. Even when the pandemic will be over, these chess players, when they will go to chessboard, they will not play for 2700. It just, they're so good in the blitz discipline. Also, can you tell me? I really like this move just because if takes, takes, king moves, this would be winning for white. But after this, I guess the problem was this, right? Would make sense. Okay. So he took, and after this, yeah, white is losing a piece. So Rebecca Harris miscalculated. He was too excited for getting this pawn and sacrificing. Even though I guess this could be correct because of this. I don't know. Too many complications, and now white is just a piece down and Night King will win this game, most likely. Night King is Bortnik, yes, and Rebecca Harris is Naroditsky. You prefer digital board? Really? Yeah. Interesting. Interesting, Einsteini. Yeah, I guess it's just because you're used to the digital era. Also, black can now not take this pawn because Rxc6? Rxc6, yeah, was very strong. There's a lot of pressure, yeah. There's a lot of pressure. What happened? Okay, they're still going on, but yeah. In fact, black... Okay, this is definitely winning, but at the end, maybe black will not even be winning this game. Who knows? Who knows? You have fancy chessboard. Okay, yeah, they look way too similar. Yeah, I do believe you, but when you look at the classical board pieces, they're very clear and it's not hard to differentiate between them. I prefer over the board chess. What about you guys? Do you prefer over the board or online? Did you watch the entire game 6 of World Chess Championship? Yes, shot locked. In fact, I actually was commentating in it in Slovenian because I had a webinar and I watched the game from beginning till end and it was very exciting. You're very anxious during over the board tournaments, me too. But also I'm very anxious in online tournaments, especially when they're very serious, so it's same thing for me. Like 26 Elo Blitz has played 3000, yeah. I don't know about that, I would say, yeah. It's But also it's blitz rating, so blitz rating is different. And also online you can pre-move, guys. When you're learning chess online, you're pre-moving, and then one day you're just gonna be over the board and you will see how quickly time ticks down. Okay, let's go to Michael. Michael is playing Gianplatti from Argentina. Who is he? Alan Pichot. Okay, Alan Pichot. And I feel like white has a great position, especially because of this attack going on right now. H4. Simple. Protect. It's okay, we exchange everything and try to save the king from perpetual. Even though it's not so simple. Because after this... Yeah. And after this, what you're gonna do, g3? Yeah, okay, this is a bit... It could be a dilemma, it could be a dilemma. This g... he's going here. And after this, are you going g3? Yeah, yes. And black has no more checks. That's lovely. Also, look at this amazing knight. Moving, putting the king out of the play. You play way more over the board, but definitely way more immersive means more to me, yeah. You want to challenge? You cannot challenge me. I'm just commentating the arena right now. You're asking for a friend, Paul. It's a secret. Oh, you were also too scared to talk to me? Einstein almost met me live and he was scared to talk to me. Interesting. Also, who won this game? White. White won this game. So, Alain Pichot beat Michael, who was also on fire today. But, you know, you have to lose some games. And actually, Alain Pichot, he came to the game late. I don't think he berserked any game. Yes, he hasn't. And he's on 5th place right now. He's on 5th place right now. So we have Dropstone, Mud Pro, MSB2. Who is MSB2 though? Let's watch MSB2 because I don't know who that is. I don't know who is MSB2. Oh, we didn't talk. Also Murska Sobota, wow. Sarin is 27 in Blitz, Fide is more than 3000. Okay, also Mikhail Tal, Blitz in real life is not played very often. For example, I play rated FIDE Blitz tournament once a year. This is how often I played a rated Blitz tournament. And my Blitz rating, FIDE rating is definitely not realistic, for example. It's Bluebaum, so it's German. He's a German player. Matthias Bluebaum, interesting. 3+2 over the board. Yeah, 3+2 or 5+0, 5+2. I play it once a year. Can you play Ultra Bullet over the board? No, there are no tournaments to play Ultra Bullet over the board. You can play it as for fun, but never in for FIDE rating. So who should we follow now? Rob? Manfo? Never Enough? Smurf? Platy? Okay, let's go to continue watching Alain Pichot. Yeah, time goes so fast. Are you commentating anywhere during World Chess Championship? I'm gonna commentate tomorrow on Rucha's channel. Rucha is a Lichess streamer as well, and I will be joining her tomorrow for the World Championship commentary, but only for an hour because I should take some rest as well. Because this stream is gonna be very long, and we have 1 hour and 54 minutes to go. It's gonna be very, very interesting. Yeah, I have to drink a lot of water. I'm just talking too much at this point. You know, also fun fact, I burnt my tongue 2 days ago, and I still feel the pain. So maybe this is also why I have trouble speaking a little bit. Who knows? Yeah, Michal Tal. We can definitely follow Gata Kamsky game. Just tell me what is his username. Just tell me what is his username and I will definitely follow. We have different lightnings here. Yeah, he is Matthias Bluebaum, yeah. Yeah, you regret it afterwards. Ah, he is IGN Gatakansky. Okay, we'll definitely watch his game. Here we go. Here you go, guys. He's playing Zavan? Okay. So Gatakansky, what's his score in this tournament? We'll see afterwards. So Baron Tang helps with the French accent? I guess so, guys. If you want to speak a perfect... Wait, let me know. If you want to speak a perfect French accent, you should definitely burn your tongue. And then maybe you will learn also the French language. It's a very beautiful language. You know, everybody says that. Yeah, FFL Gata. Yeah, okay, so this is definitely winning because of this pawn. If there was not this pawn, it would be a draw, but also with 13 seconds, it's impossible to hold a draw. So Gatakansky won. Okay, let's wait for his next game so we can follow him from the beginning till the end. Have milk. It doesn't help, guys. It doesn't help. When your tongue is burnt, it's burnt. Okay, he's playing Dropstone number one, and they're both berserking 1 minute and 30 seconds for both players. They don't even play Blitz, and Gatakansky sacrificing, playing Scandinavian, and then sacrificing a pawn in the opening for the opening development advantage. Is this still on theory? I guess this is some blitz theory. Knight d7 is forced, otherwise second move would be king e7, queen d7 was impossible because losing the rook, bishop e7, now he's attacking the pawn, very smart. What to do now? Rook c8, very logical. But what now? Now this is a threat, maybe bishop f6. Oh, he castles, gives the pawn away because he's calculated. What did he calculate? It's two pawns down for black. Okay, let's say we takes back, and then play c3. Does white have any problems? Okay, rook d8, but... Okay, he's just gonna give up the pawn. Well, that's easy. That's easy. Now black is doing great. Now black's not even a pawn down anymore. He's losing this pawn though, so... So, okay, after this, we should see rook b1, checkmate threat, we should see some h5 now, or okay, f5. f5 is usually not the best, just because if rook does come to 7th rank, king doesn't really have much options to go through, but okay, it doesn't matter. Dropstone is lower on time, he has 40 seconds against 50 seconds, so... Pawn is still here, okay, what if we see bishop f8? What if we see bishop f8? However, 27 seconds. Ah, we see bishop d5. That's the trick, taking on f2. That makes a lot of sense, actually. And now just rook f3 or something. Okay, he's going here to keep the tension here on the king. In fact, if king comes to f3, white king will actually be checkmated. Scandi mother, and yes, two pawns down. Easy GG for them, yeah. Hang out? No, not really, Einstein. No, not really. Okay, so we see h3. Suddenly, Kamsky is the one that's playing for the win. And in fact, he's gonna win this game. First, we give a check, I guess. Oh, he's just gonna queen. Oh, wow, what a beautiful way to win. Just gonna queen and go rook h3 and take the bishop. So Kamsky is on fire. Let's just check how many points he has. Kamsky, he started really badly. He lost a lot of games in the beginning, and then he started playing amazingly and is now on 5th place. Gatakansky currently on 5th place. I know you cannot see it, but he's currently here on 5th place. And let's watch another game of him. We can watch Dania definitely as well. After this game, we can maybe move to Dania. He's playing a strong national master. He's also, this national master is on fire right now. Kamsky using external help. No, he's just a FF legend. But I think he blundered a pawn here because this one is hanging and also this one. So the best move would apparently be knight g1 to protect everything, but he decided to give this pawn, or maybe blundered, who knows. And Kamsky, he berserked, however, Anem Smurf, he didn't berserk. What's going on with the queen on d8? He's going to c7, okay. Knight g5, trying to figure out what's the idea, I'm basically just moving the knight. Okay, takes, no problem. And what's gonna happen now? Will he take? Oh, he will. And takes, okay. Now, basically, this pawn structure, pawn chain is amazing. I do love it. I would like to have it in my games as well. But Kamsky again is a pawn down. I guess if I could make a few moves for Kamsky, king e2, queen h1, queen h8. This is idea. That's why bishop e7 is a good move. You have to get rid of this bishop. Oh, king f8, he's playing for a win. So he's playing for a win. However, I feel like this is still idea white could take. You take white here. Yes, this black queen is terrible. It's just absolutely terrible. But at least king went here. Okay, now what Kamsky will try to do, he will not go for this plan because now king went here and he has no problems. White will just go here, try to play for this pawn somehow. Not gonna sack on b7? Not yet. Soon? Nah, he will not sack. He will just take it for free. He will just take it for free. I guess black will take this bishop because this bishop is very annoying on this diagonal. But black can now not protect the pawn. And this pawn, which is on b6, is only 2 squares away from queening. So, for example, now queen c7 or knight c6 or queen c6 is just all a good idea. Let's see if... Yeah, now he's just taking all the pawns for free. So he was a pawn down, now he's 2 pawns up. Easy GG. Where do we move the bishop? H2? Oh, he's not even moving the bishop. Okay, Kamsky. Yeah, black queen is so locked. And Kamsky is just saying, I don't even need my pieces. I'm just gonna queen and you should definitely just resign. He has 33 seconds though, which is not... actually, this is not so clear. What if I take and then queen comes to h2? What? Ah, the idea was queen d5. The idea was queen d5 and just take the knight. Okay. It was clear. It was all clear. Wait. What? Isn't this checkmate? Oh my god, Kamsky blundered the checkmate! Kamsky blundered the checkmate! Oh my god, wait! Kamsky blundered the checkmate in a completely winning position! What? He was just so... Okay, that was unexpected. That was unexpected. Okay, let's go. You know, let's go. Watch Naroditsky now. Yeah, that was definitely unexpected. I don't know what just happened here. Don't know what just happened here. That's why blitz is fun, exactly. You know how much rage Kamsky has to have after losing that game? He's probably just so angry at himself. Rebecca Harris has a pawn up. However, if he takes, this pawn is hanging and potentially this one. So he has to make a choice how to play this. They're opposite color bishops, which should be enough to hold a draw with white. Wow, la 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 la. Rebecca Harris just winning. Rebecca Harris just winning. He just won. Yeah, this blunder has to put him on tilt. Too confident at the end. Yeah, I think he just... You know what I'm gonna tell you? He thought queen h2 idea was nothing at all. He just thought that queen h2 was not such a huge threat. He underestimated it and then he realized, well, it's a huge threat. It happens, yeah. Kamsk is always on tilt, I guess so. I guess so. It's in his DNA, right? Okay, so they both berserk, they both have 1 minute 30. Dropstone still number 1 in the arena, still leading the arena with how many points? Still leading the arena with only 2 points ahead. Only 2 points ahead of the second place. He was 13 points above second place and now only 2. Yeah, and let's see what's gonna happen in this game. White has 2 bishops, white has amazing, beautiful center. Look at these beautiful pawns. You know, if I could have any pawns, I would just have e4, f4, and d4. But okay, these two are also fine. Okay, this pawn, this bishop is doing its job, I have to say. It's working. Just gonna change the music. Okay, what happened here? 55 seconds, Rebecca Harris blitzing out the moves. You know, bishop pair is nice, however, how do you use this bishop on f1? How do you take advantage of having bishop on f1? This is a terrible bishop. I prefer the knight on c5 than bishop on f1. I guess the idea is to now to take and just take here. Yeah, this is what Rebecca Harris will do and says, okay, I'm a pawn up, I'm taking another one here. Okay, this is now a huge threat. And that's why king f2 played. But now, okay, let's see. Let's say rook c1. Now, this is gonna be a huge threat. This is gonna be now a huge threat and losing the bishop. So what will white do? Ah, he just takes. Okay, very easy. And now it's playing this endgame with a pawn up, which is theoretically a draw. But let's see if Rebecca Harris with 35 seconds can beat Dropstone with 22 seconds. Let's go, Dania! You're cheering for Dania, yeah? So yeah, this should definitely be a draw. But in Blitz game, everything's possible. Greetings from Holland, greetings from Slovenia. Okay, well, I mean, white can push b7, definitely, but definitely this king is way too active here. Way too active here. And even... Yeah, g4, I guess, would be a very strong. First we check, and then, okay. Yeah, now we just go g4, or take. Both is good. I don't like this move. I don't like this move, but okay. 5 seconds, though. Rebecca Harris did win this game. So, this was theoretically a draw, but you know, in Blitz anything can happen, and Rebecca Harris won against Dropstone. Dropstone is dropping. Dropstone is dropping to second place. Now Michael is leading Mikola, so Mikola Bortnik is leading. Because Dropstone lost another game and he's definitely on tilt. He was on fire and then he went on tilt. Just like, and then tilt. And Michael is now first place. Let's watch Michael then. Michael is playing Matthias Blumbaum from Germany, very strong grandmaster. While Mikola is international master from Ukraine originally. So, what's this? Nikola has always such interesting positions. Do you dare to say that Nikolai could already be winning? Because now this bishop is hanging. The question is, do I take? Oh, okay, that was disappointing. Basically, I was calculating just like some lines, takes, bishop b5 or something like bishop g6, but he just decided to play this and... What? Why can't I just not take the rook? Okay. I think Mikola is just winning this. I think Mikola is just winning, and Blumbaum actually just resigned in this second when I said that. Yeah, I think this was already... Mikola won in 22 moves against Blumbaum. Interesting. Okay, let's go to the next game. Now, Mikhail is first place. Let's go Ukraine, Dropstone, Russia, and Matpro, Vietnam. Matpro still very, very high. Let's go watch Rebecca Harris. Wow, look at this pawn on h3. Look at this pawn on h3. If rook not here, queen g2 checkmate. But okay, now queen... What? Wait. Did black just blunder the queen? Black just blundered the queen. Okay. Rebecca Harris has no troubles. Just winning the queen and winning the game. Okay, let's watch next game. Let's see if we're gonna see a Rui Lopez. Ooh, f5. Look at this. f5. Dania too strong. Yes, way too strong. Dania is now number 3 on the standings list. Nikolai is still leading, drops on second, Rebecca Harris now third. Wait, what happened? Okay, so now these guys, this is very interesting theory. I played this with black myself and I have to say it's very exciting to play. But I have to say white played very well. Oh, knight e6 now. And then maybe long castle. Okay, bishop here is very good. You get rid of this bishop on this good diagonal. And then when takes, I can either short castle or long castle. It's both probably good. Okay, now we take. Okay, I'm not sure I like what happened here, because these two bishops that are gonna be in pair are gonna be huge, and white is now on a pawn up and a bishop pair up. Would I take this bishop? Why not? It's not such a big deal. I would. And now the threat is rook e7. That's why rook e8 played. Okay, just moving on. Okay. He beats Karana in classical game. Dania, yeah, he did beat Karana in classical game in this US Chess Championship this year. Hey, behold, how are you doing? Do you prefer to compete blitz game or classical game? So honestly, blitz games go by way too fast. But before I went on this stream, I thought it's okay. It's gonna be very exciting, it's gonna be easy to commentate, you know. The games are gonna be exciting, but actually it's very hard to commentate because usually when you commentate, you would like to explain why the move was played, why is this position better for white or black, what are the ideas, and you would like to have time to think about that as well. So actually it's better to commentate classical games because you can actually say a lot about the position and you can think about it before you say something. Here, just say, oh look, rook is under attack. Black has to move the rook. This is all I can say because then black moves the rook and now it's already like different. Why did white not play this though? Okay, I guess there's something behind it that I did not see. Why is he giving up the pawn? Somebody in the chat like, why is black giving up the pawns? So king f8 now on the board. White, I guess, cannot take this, even though I think he could. I guess he could not take because of this, but then I played this, but then check. So I think white could take this. My guess. How can I evaluate this position? I don't know. I just know that black's a pawn up for now, even though this pawn should be hanging. Who is better? I don't know. I just don't know. Both kings are cut off from the game. So guys, tell me. How are you doing? How are you holding up? Which games do you want to see? We can also talk about the World Championship a bit, you know. These games are hard to commentate. It's very hard to understand them because they change with every move. It's just interesting to watch the tactics that happen at the end. Let's keep watching Dania, sure. So, okay, I mean, Dania will push this pawn, but also, like, Chessmaster can start pushing this pawn. Dania is faster though, which is important that you're faster. Do you have a favorite bed opening? favorite bad opening? The French. What about you guys? I guess I think this is objectively a draw. I'm just gonna say that this is objectively a draw, but anything can happen. Should be a draw, I guess. Yeah, even though, yeah, black is now losing the pawn, but also white is losing the pawn, so this game should be a draw. Chessmaster is Prana. Huh, okay. What do you think about game 6 and Magnus winning? I think the game was very interesting, especially when before move 40 they were both very low on time and there was no 30 seconds increment. You love the French? Yeah. I me too. My pet bullet opening is g4. Wow. The grob. Wait, what? Why not taking? Okay, whatever. Whatever. Oh, why? Okay, so Rebecca Harris is now playing for a win. You know, he could just take the rook and say, okay, draw, thank you, goodbye. And basically what? Daniel is playing for the win on time? I don't understand. I don't understand. He's playing on time, I guess, but does he have to win? Okay. Fourteen seconds against 12 seconds. Eleven against 9 seconds. Let's just watch the time. Let's just watch the time. Pay attention to the time, guys. This is very important. Okay, it's not important anymore. It's a draw. It's a draw. Yeah, why draw when you can dirty flag? Because he was so far away from dirty flagging, you know? It was not even on my mind when he decided, oh yeah, let's dirty flag. Many legend past players will roll in their grave if you say that anything wrong about French. Yeah, but they didn't live in the time where Stockfish and Lila Zero and Alpha Zero and all the new engines were a thing. And yeah, with these new engines you can definitely say that they're not really, it's not really a great opening, I guess. The title sharks are eating each other again in the blitz, yeah. Just dirty flagging each other. Also, this is a very nice position. I like that my pawn is here on c5. Yeah, okay, we lost the pawn, but we have beautiful e-file and b-file to take advantage of. Okay, Rebecca Harris playing against Knight King, against Bortnik. So we have Dania against Naroditsky. Not Dania against Naroditsky. Dania against Alexander Bortnik right now. Is there any super GM now and plays the French? Yeah, yeah, like actually Napomniachi, he plays the French. But guys, let's think about it. Napomniachi is playing the French usually, but he's not playing the World Championship match. Do you think he will ever play the French in the World Championship match? Do you think that or no? And that tells you. If he will, okay, that means it's still a good opening. If he will not, it means we should, you know, it's not like officially a good opening. It's good opening on different levels. I guess it's not good opening on the top level. I do like, look at these beautiful black squares. Ooh, these beautiful black squares. I would like to take advantage of them so much, but if I go here, just bishop will take it very sadly. Like, my dream here would be to put the knight somewhere where it can go on f6 on h6. That would be amazing, preferably on f6. Like, let's put the knight on e4 or here. It's fine. Okay, maybe start with this, but what after takes? Okay, I think we blundered. What? I think Rebecca blundered. Okay, here I think this was supposed to be played takes, takes and takes. I think this is what should be on the board, but it wasn't. And I think that was a blunder. Yeah, this was a blunder. That Rebecca Harris blundered. Rebecca Harris blundered terribly. This was terrible blunder. Terrible blunder. Terrible blunder by Dania. In fact, like, this position was so good for white. And then here he should have just taken with the rook and then give checks to the king and then bring the knight to e6, maybe play for a win this way. But yeah, now he's playing drop stone. They both berserked, as usual. Wait, okay, will he play the king gambit? No, no, I don't think he will. I don't think he'll play the French, but what about the Sicilian? He could play the Sicilian, yeah, definitely. So you're saying we should all play the Petrov? No, definitely not saying that. Maybe when, if you're gonna be 28 and you really want to draw, definitely play the Petrov, yeah. Who's the expert in the French opening? There are some players that are experts in the French opening. I think Nepo is one of them, in a way. Nepo does not Magnus does not recommend the French, okay. What do you think about the Catalan at the top level? Michal Tal, that's a very good question, because when Magnus played the Catalan, I was very surprised. Because Catalan does not give advantage for white. It's actually equal by the new modern chess technique. So it was very surprising that Magnus played it, but actually I was very happy that it was played as well. Why is he thinking? He just wants to go here. Yeah, I was very happy that it was played and it showed that Catalan is not so naive. It's actually a very nice opening. It's hard to play against as a human. Nepo will break out the Sicilian near end of the match, I guess so. But I think Magnus will not be playing e4. Maybe he will, who knows. Both Italians in Sicilian are very sharp. He would donate if he had the money. Oh, Enviel, he's French. You know, Enviel is the expert in Greenfield and in the Nydorf. Because that's all he plays. So he cannot really be expert in the French. What happened to the queen? Very good question. Queen got destroyed. You revoke. Ah, you revoke. Okay. Yes. And also Vitugo, I think he's a good French player, if I remember correctly. Do you think the rooks are stronger than the queen in most of the position? Shotlot. See, these material imbalances do depend on the position. Like, some people say, oh, two bishops are... bishop is much stronger than knight, but it's not true. It depends on the position. And two rooks are easier to play than just with one queen, because two rooks connected, you have two pieces that you can move, while queen is just one piece. And even though, like, it's supposed to be equal or da-da-da, whatever, it's much easier to play with two rooks. Mambiel will be expert in baguettes. If the white king lands on d6 in the French, you're usually in big trouble. What? will you speak in French if you meet Mambiel? I did meet MVL and I did definitely not speak in the French. In the French. Speak French. No. We not speak French, ma chérie, here. We speak only in French accent. but definitely not speaking French. Definitely not. And Rebecca Harris won this game. What happened to the queen here? So, I think... Why did that happen? Was this queen trapped if I play rook h7? Yeah, so black made... Well... Wait, was this the French opening, by the way? Was this a French opening? Oh, did we talk about the French and the French was played? Insane. Rebecca Harris so fast. I agree, so fast. Let's see who's leading the tournament. Let's maybe change to a different player for a second. Dropstone is back on number one spot with 74 points, with Mikolai on the second place with 73 points and Rebecca Harris on the third place with 66 points. Where is Gata Kamsky? Did Gata Kamsky quit? Did he rage quit? Yeah, Gata Kamsky rage quit. Gata Kamsky rage quit. Okay, fun fact, he did rage quit. Okay, let's go back to watching Naroditsky. Not sure, didn't see the start of the game. Yeah, I me neither. This is spirits? Yeah, this is spirits. You know, I used to play spirits myself as well. And Vasya Pirc, was he Slovenian player? I think he was a Slovenian player. Okay, let's go. This is the current position right now. On fire, tilt on fire again, just like crypto. Why did Magnus not join? I don't know, but it was very rude he did not join today. I mean, did he have anything better to do than play today's arena? I don't think so. Ooh, this is a terrible night here. Ooh, Rebecca Harris suffering. Suffering and lost. He resigned against Heisenberg. Rebecca Harris lost this game. That was terrible. And whenever Knight lands on C2 with this terrible pin, you should definitely not be happy. You played Pierce when you first started playing chess and you hated myself most of the time. Same. That's why I stopped playing it and started playing the French instead, because it's so much better. They're both suffering in any case. He's playing World Championship, he's preparing every day for the next day. No, it's definitely... No, he was joking. Tissin was also joking for sure. Yeah, he definitely should not be playing this arena. It's also 1 AM in Dubai and he should be sleeping. Modern openings need a lot of accuracy and technique. Mostly, yeah, definitely, of course, but they also need a lot of understanding why is it played this way now and not the old way and so on. This is a boring opening. I'm sorry to tell you, but this is a boring opening. So let's just watch the game slowly. Okay, now white will take and take and take. Interesting. Okay. Yeah, well, white could not take here because of this. Or this. Okay, now this bishop can be extremely strong if white does not block it. Okay, we have d4 on the board, with this blocking the bishop, so of course white should not take this. Ah, now we're taking on h4. Now we have to activate the king. What's the pawn count? It's equal, but it's just weird. I don't like these pawns. I prefer white pawn structure. I definitely prefer white pawn structure. Do you have Lichess account? Of course I do. What do seconds do during World Chess Championship? Yes, whenever the game is played, you know, of course, usually the opponent could try deviating from some lines, and during the World Championship they will definitely go through these lines after the game is played and find something new with the computer. That's why, for example, Magnus, today he played Rook B8 again, but he would not play the same game as the last time, but he would find the improvement in the play. And this is because his seconds found it after the game was played. White is winning this, no? White is just winning this with 2 seconds though. He has 2 seconds. Yeah, he will definitely win this with 1 second on the clock. Yeah, checkmate! Lichess title arena more prestigious than the World Championship. Yeah, I wouldn't say so, but yeah. Do I have a second to... No. No, I don't. Who should we watch now? Knight King now on the third place! The Bortnik brothers on second and third place now, guys. Let's watch Bortnik. He won all his games, last 5 games. What are my favorite openings? I do love the Catalan. And, you know, the Queen's Gambit. And, I like the Caro, I like the French. I prefer the Caro these days because it's a bit more open. White is winning, by the way. Bortnik is winning again. Bortnik is just winning again. 3 seconds, but he's winning. Bortnik winning, easy GG. Bortnik on fire. I think this is his sixth win. You like Vienna Gambit? The thing is, I'm not E4 player, so I don't know a lot of these gambits. I am a D4 player. Poor Dania, yeah. Yeah, they are brothers. Yes, and they are brothers. I think I'm almost 100% sure that Mikola and Alexander Bortnik are brothers. Have I ever been a second for someone else? No, no. Laura is more positional like Carpo and Petrosian. I am a dynamic player, but I wouldn't call myself a positional player, but I do enjoy positional games as well. Depends on the mood. When I feel a bit lazy, I love playing positional and just very slow chess. But when I'm in great form, so when I play my best, I am a very good dynamical player. You like the Polish opening? What is the Polish opening? Reminder to drink water. You know, water is almost empty. We'll have to refill. What's good line against London? C5, definitely. Be active. If your opponent doesn't want to be active, you should be active. Knight G5, I love this. Look at this beautiful pawn here. Also, I would love to see some sacrifice right here. I love Queen D3 move as well, because the idea is actually Queen Rook H4. After taking, this is checkmate. Whoa, we see some... This is dynamic play, so this is dynamic play I'm talking about. However, I don't think this is correct. I think... I think White did not play this perfectly. 1b4 is Polish? Wait, isn't 1b4 orangutan? When I was young, 1b4 was called orangutan. Huh, interesting, I didn't know it was Polish. You always struggle against the King's Indian when you play London? Yeah, because against King's Indian you should take all the center. That's why I have advice for you, Worm Slayer. Against King's Indian, so when your player plays against d4, knight f6, play knight f3, and after g6, don't play bishop f4, but play bishop g5. Play bishop g5, knight d2, and then e4. This is the best way to try playing against the King's Indian if you don't want to play c4. The technical name is Polish, wow. Guys, I think Knight King is losing this game, and again, he was winning 6 games in a row, and then I started watching and he's gonna lose. I'm not bringing good luck. However, his opponent has 5 seconds on the clock. 5 seconds on the clock, is that enough time to win the game? I think it's enough time to win the game. With this pre-moving black has, it's enough time. And bishop here, okay. Ooh, no, it's not gonna be enough time. It's not gonna be enough time. He lost. Okay, wow. Oh, wow, so who won the game? Black, white won, so on time. The thing is that black, if black didn't give this pawn away, black won, white won this game now, but if black didn't blunder, if black here just played this would be winning. But Bortnik, lucky guy, he won this game. What do you think about of 2b3 against the French? Always play it in bullet and blitz against e4 e6. I think it's good for bullet and blitz, but not for classical chess. What is the line that annoys you the most against d4? The line that annoys me the most. Okay, so the line that annoys me the most is against when if I play the Catalan, and if my opponent plays bishop b4 check and after bishop b2 a5, I have very bad score against this line, and it's annoying me the most because I just cannot, I don't know, I just cannot play well against this line for some reason. Hello, hello, Mr. Aishas. Mr. Aishas came to say hello to the Lichess stream. Hello, how are you doing, Aishas? How was Dubai? Were you enjoying it? So excited about Blitz Chess Championship, yes. Is this stream mirrored? Is the chessboard sideways? Depends how you look at it. Yeah, it's not exactly correct because the gold square is on the left. It's not mirrored, it's just that I put it down this way. Dubai was warm and now you're back in Norway. So it's not warm anymore, huh? It's just... Oh, whoa, what's going on? Now this is not a threat, but this is a good move, trying to exchange the queen so the attack disappears. No snow there as opposed to Oslo. Yeah. Yeah. I believe you. Dubai is warm. We also have snow in Slovenia, so it's pretty good. Oh, Aishas has new emotes! That's so cool. Guys, Aishas, he's a Lichess mod and he's also a streamer, so you can definitely drop him a follow or subscribe. Depends how much he streams, but his streams are very entertaining. Depends on the hour of the night when he streams. It can be very dangerous if black takes d5. Adorable accent. Thank you. Where do you think the accent is from? You're welcome, Aishas. You're welcome. Okay, so rook was... Okay, so white is now just playing crushing. Yeah, also, no time for Bortnik. White is crushing. Look at the bishop. Look at the knight. Look at this rook coming to h6. Crazy. And Bortnik lost. After 7 games, he lost some luck. And we have 1 hour and 11 minutes left to go. Do you think Magnus would join this titled arena? You know, Aishas, actually, we were talking about this most of the time on the stream, that how ridiculous it would be if Magnus actually went to join this titled arena. I think it would be like crazy to, like, for example, if I were Nepo and Magnus went to play titled arena instead of preparing for the match or sleeping, that would just be crazy. Yeah, he's just winning the world championship. You change your channel name? No. I'm sure he must be itching to join, but his seconds would have told him to sleep. Yeah, I guess so. Michael is now leading. Guys, so we have Dropstone, who was on the first place for a long time, but now he lost 3 games in a row. And Mikolaj Bortnik, brother of Aleksandar Bortnik, is now leading and they're actually playing each other. Guys, this is exciting. Brothers are playing each other right now, probably for maybe even first place. East Europe? Yeah, could be, somewhere around there. You know, I would call my country part of Middle Europe. Not central, but middle. Certainly would be a flex. Yeah, it would be a flex, yeah. It would feel disrespect. Exactly. It would be the biggest insult. Okay, it would not be that bad. Look at this beautiful move, knight c4. The queen cannot go here because this pawn is hanging, and if the queen moves somewhere here, this pawn is hangado. So yeah, now we take this one. I have to get a water refill at some point. Yes, Slovenia, Rush, Slovenia, exactly, that's correct. The country with pretty warm moon. Okay, whoa, did I say that white was supposed to be winning? Yeah, I think I blundered this as well. I just blundered this. And look, guys, now we have two rooks against a queen, which we were talking about before. And this is going to be a good example of how much easier is it going to be to play with two rooks as opposed to just a queen. I have a Twitch channel. Yes, I have a Twitch channel. It's called Chiquitas. Is Melania a big celebrity in Slovenia? No, not at all. Slovenia is Balkan. Yes, we're still part of the Balkan. Even though Balkan countries don't accept us to be Balkan. So for example, now we could go here. I don't think this is an issue. And after check, just king h7. And this pawn is just hanging. So I think... I think it's much easier to play for black here. Like Magnus yesterday, yeah. Media people asking some weird questions in press conference after World Chess Championship games. Really? No, I don't think they're weird mostly. Oh, so guys, the battle between Mikolaj Bortnik and Aleksandar Bortnik will actually be won by the weaker brother, the international master brother. Mikolaj is actually winning, and this is just how easy it's to play with two rooks as opposed to just a queen. So Mikolaj won against his brother Aleksandar. So Mikolaj currently leading the title, the arena, and we have more than one hour to go. I love the way Europeans pronounce it, rook. Yeah, but how do non-Europeans pronounce it? Rook? I don't know how else to pronounce it. The rook. Is the younger brother winning on time? No, he was also winning in the position, but also on time. So now we have Mikolaj winning the arena's drop stone on the second place. Let's check on drop stone. Drop stone, are you gonna win some game or not? Dropstone, are you gonna win? It looks like this game is actually definitely not winning for black. It's actually the opposite, it's winning for white. So dropstone just not finding the untilting mode. More like rook. Ooh, dropstone losing another game. He might be dropping down to third place soon. Adias Magnus, how the knight moves? No, Dilly. It's actually. I'm gonna show you the meaning behind this question. Okay. I'm just gonna show you. Okay. I'm just gonna show you why. Why this was asked. No, guys, you don't understand why this happened, and I'm gonna show you why. I know it's now viral, and you know... they even made a video about the chess drama. Oh, no, it's not here. Yes, this one. Okay, so The point... is here. Let's quickly just discuss this. Okay. So this is the point. What? So this was the stream before the World Championship.
Let's try this one. How do knights move?
What? What the hell are you saying? I know very well how the knights move, Magnus.
Okay, so the point was that, of course, she was a bit, like, embarrassed that Magnus had to ask that on her own stream. Sorry, guys. And, like, she decided she will embarrass him in the World Championship, I guess. Okay. So this was the whole point behind it. it makes sense. It's not like, okay, this is stupid, you know? Like, it makes sense. Okay, let's watch another game. Let's watch Mikhail, he's now leading the arena. The transcript of Big Hick reaction is hilarious. No, of course there's a lot of drama about it now, but okay, it's like... It makes sense in a way. All these lame questions are just a waste of everyone's time. No, these sparks, I don't agree. The press conference after is very interesting, especially for the media. Why is chess getting sponsors? Why is chess getting popularity? It's only because of the media. And if the media can have inside answers to some questions, why did, for example, Magnus play knight d6? What was the insight? You know, we need something to write about for chess to be more popular, for chess to get better recognition, for chess to have more sponsors and more visibility in the future. These questions are not a waste of anyone's time. In fact, questions are good to be asked to get inside information. If I had to ask Magnus one question at the press conference, I would probably ask, like, related to the game. Like, how did he feel that he did not play any active move? Or, I don't know, what was his plan in this position? Why did he decide to play this line? Or something like that, you know? Yeah, I love watching the press conference. Such a complicated game, sorry. Yeah, okay, let's go back to the games. Yeah, this is complicated. What's actually going on? I don't really understand. Knight goes to f6. And what if I just go here? Why could I just not take here? Okay, whatever. I think black blundered. How long will this tournament take? It takes 3 hours, guys. The tournament is extremely long. It takes... Look at this beauty! Look at this beauty! If knight takes, this is checkmate! This is why chess is beautiful. Checkmate with two knights. Come on, Michael. You could at least make you checkmate with two knights. Yeah, I would ask him how does the rook move. Yeah, sure. I think chess should remain elitist. I do not think it's productive to invite the unwashed masses to the intellectual rages of chess. No, I do agree, right? I think chess, like, is a very royal game, and, like, making 1500 players, like, talking about PogChamps play, popularize the game, it's not exactly, like, the smartest move. However, it's a smart move for people to use chess platforms, and this is what chess platforms want to do, for example, as chess.com. However, chess in classical way will still remain the same, very royal. Wow, Night King also got mated. The Bortnik brothers got getting mated. Guys, 1 hour left to go in this tournament. This has been such a long tournament, which we still have 1 hour to go. Mikolaj still leading the tournament. Dropstone very close by on the second place, and Bortnik Alexander on the third place. Where is Rebecca Harris? Let's watch Rebecca Harris a little bit. We have not watched Rebecca in a while. Let's watch Rebecca for a little bit. I've been watching the matches. For some people, the issue is they don't have 4 to 7 hours to watch a chess game. Yeah. I'm lucky I have time to watch the whole game. Silly media question to Magnus, which soccer player would you compare Nepo with? Okay, this is a stupid question. Yeah, I do agree this is a stupid question. You cannot really do that. Do you like Capture Fest? Like the one which happened today that would... No, not really, I guess. Yeah, okay, so let's watch Naroditsky and... Yeah, I'm slowly losing energy to talk in any accent, so I'm just gonna try to talk about chess. Ooh, rook d7, this is a dirty rook here. You definitely don't want your opponent to bring the rook to d7. However, yeah, now the queen is coming. This is pinned, which is very uncomfortable. This is very uncomfortable for white. If black could just play g5 and g4, we'd even blunder. Rook d8, strong move. Such a strong move. And Rebecca Harris won the game. Easy GG, 31 moves, winning the rook. Is the queen trapped? No, queen can go here, but the rook is lost. So, GG, GG. You think chess should become an e-sport? There will also... Yeah, I think blitz and bullet could be e-sport. But classical chess should still be where it is. Yeah, chess.com had more viewers than Valorant. I saw, I was watching. They had 140,000 viewers yesterday. Yeah. Bishop f6. Yeah, bishop f6. Yeah, that was lovely. You could compare Zlatan Ibrahimovic with Nepa. Zlatan Ibrahimovic is a legend. No, does Daniel stream? No, I didn't think he's streaming, but Zhigalko is streaming, his opponent. Zhigalko, however, has not started well, but is now playing very, very well. Magnus was trending on Twitter yesterday, I didn't know. I don't have Twitter, I should make Twitter though. How do I even commentate this game? Tell me, bishop is on h3. What is this bishop doing on h3? Very good question. Is white going to play g3? No, because this is now happening. Why would you go bishop c8? Okay, I guess it makes some sense as well, but okay. This bishop was very weird on h3. But also the idea of bishop c8 was to bring the rook to c8, so that makes sense. Ooh, and e4 now giving a beautiful square to this knight on d4. This one's now under attack. Will black play b4? I don't think black has much choice but to play b4 in this position. I hate this pawn structure. However, black has to do something regarding this knight, maybe bringing it to c4. Of course, b4 was almost forced. This was attacked. You got streaming in Russian, okay, yeah. I don't think that Zlatan paid to shoot a lion has the head and skin in his house. Blitz chess could be sported the Olympics. Yeah, definitely. I agree. Bishop chilling there, not anymore. okay, so how will this endgame end? I think this is a beautiful pass pawn. So, but the problem is that this is a terrible pawn. Now we will check. I don't know, knight h5? I would go knight h5 and knight g3. Honestly, I would. Just go knight h5. Come on. Do it. No, not h5. Go knight h5, knight g3. Okay, you can go h4. You know, I forgive you. Go h4. thank you. And now knight h5. Okay, not yet. Sure. Good. No, the thing is that I want to go knight h5, knight g3, and if king cannot go to g1, because that would be checkmate. That would be checkmate. The problem with chess as a sport is that there's little active movement and most people associate with sport. Okay, but there's the competitive factor. What about the competitive factor? There's a competition, and this is what makes chess a sport. And also that, yeah, there's a little movement, but there's a competition, and the competition of one game can sometimes last for 8 hours, as we saw yesterday. And this is just one game out of 10 games played. Imagine how much brain movement that is. Even imagine what happens in the brain in 8 hours of one game. So much brain gains, guys. So much brain gains. You would also rate Bobby Fischer genius as 7 as rated by Magnus. See, the thing is that Bobby Fischer might have been a genius, but he was also very crazy, so... you know, there's a small line between genius and crazy. I think that's why 7. Hello, our pair, hello. Pieces have a lot of weight. If we put 5 kilo in each piece, guys, you know how many gains we would have in our bicep? We have the strong argument if we put the weight on pieces. That's so funny. Okay, we're making chess sport, guys. We're making it together right here on the Lichess stream. Yeah, till you rage quit. Yeah. It's rage quitting in chess is extremely easy. It's terrible. Okay, I would not really go knight g5. Sorry, my lights turned off. Maybe I would go bishop g5. I would love this pin. But actually, these knights are lovely. This game is going on by so fast. I cannot even follow. Let's go, Dania! Who's last gladiator? Last gladiator is... Ah, okay, we already had him. I already forgot. I just use the chessboard like in Harry Potter, yeah. There's a ghost behind me. Yeah, totally. Okay, so how would this game end? Honestly, these pawns are very well protected. Dan is going for typical h4, h5 break. Was this good? I think it's usually good. Would I take on h6 now? Okay, he's decided not to go for it. I think this was a mistake. I think black should definitely exchange the queens. Or not, I don't know, maybe I was wrong. But definitely this king behind these pawns is not very safe. I would not go for it. But if he did exchange the queens, I think this pawn were hanged, so... He had an argument. He had an argument. Oh, now we take. Now we take. Come on. Ah, we could not take. Okay, see guys, I'm getting very tired. It's been 2 hours and 10 minutes and... you know, this would happen, but then after this... Yeah, okay, so this was way too complicated to calculate, so Naroditsky decided to go for this endgame with a pawn down, which is a draw. But will he make a draw? That's a different question. Let's go here. Okay, no, that's fine. Let's go here, come on, let's go. After this we take, okay, we just take this one. Take it, and then take it. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Now let's make a draw. Actually, Naroditsky will try to flag. He will try to play and flag him because he has 10 seconds. Naroditsky will not flag him. Let's watch this, guys. This is what Blitz is all about. This is why Tanya decided to play chess professionally. To play for the flag. Look at this beautiful 3 seconds. 2 seconds. 1 second. Where's the flag? Flag, 1 second, come on. Half a second, and he lost. You know, Dania is just a perfect flagger, what can you say? What's my FIDE? My FIDE used to be 2400. What would you recommend how to learn opening repertoire? Oof. Just start with some small lines from the books, I would say, or on the new websites. Like Chessable or something like that. King is 100 kilograms. What did you smoke or drink? Can I have some? Water. I drank the whole bottle of water and now I'm thirsty. And yeah. Life is all about the flags, exactly. The way you speak... This seems fascinating. What do you mean? Oh yeah, we have an opening tree on Lichess. If you want to learn the openings, definitely go to Lichess opening tree. But the thing is that as the beginning to get a line, it's easier to open a book and see what the writer in the book said. You said, okay, this is the line, this is the side line, and this is the third side line. And then you learn this, and it's easy when somebody just gives you the lines. Well, on the Lichess opening book, like, you have to, like, you get a certain position, and then you're like, what is it? How? What's the evaluation? What's my idea? Okay, who played this? Okay, these players played this, but what does that tell me? Nothing much. So it's just at the beginning, it's easier to like get a book and somebody to explain you what's the point of the position, what's the idea of the position, how do I play this after the opening is over. This is hard work for non-English speakers. Yeah, as you can hear, I'm struggling to speak sometimes. Wow, 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 this is beautiful, wow. Okay, this is not clear. We have bishop and three pawns. I think black is actually, even dare say, winning in this position, because bishop and three pawns for one rook are more than enough for the advantage. Especially if I could go something like f5 and just win a rook. Especially after this. I think Dania is winning, and then after this we're checking the standings. After this we're checking the standings. What the hell just happened? Yeah, exactly. What the hell just happened? Some exchanges were made, and this is why it's so hard to commentate. It's hard to comprehend what happens all the time. Okay, guys, let's look at the standings. So thank you for the follows for Chiquita's channel. That's why MVL appeared. You know, guys, for entertainment, let me just show you. Let me just show you what we do on the Chiquita's channel. Just so to get you in a better mood. Okay, the leader of the tournament 46 minutes before it's over is Knight King, who is Alexander Bortnik from originally Ukraine, currently living in the USA. Second place is Mikolai Bortnik, brother of Alexander Bortnik. Currently second place. Third place, Dropstone from Russia. Fourth place, Rebecca Harris. Fifth place, Mitrabha. Mitrabha, we didn't follow his games, so maybe we should start with following his games. Now. King's never getting checkmate behind the barrier. True. How are you supposed to follow? You downloaded Twitch 10 minutes ago. Yeah, I don't know how to explain this. There's just a follow button somewhere around it. It's not open the stream and then it's a follow, that's all. Is MVL streaming in Chiquita's channel as well? Sadly, no. Sadly, that's our lifetime goal though. Follow your heart, exactly. Just follow your heart, that's lovely. What is this position? Okay, I think this is good position for white, if I remember correctly, should be. Okay, black decided to sacrifice pawn for activity. So knight c5 could be coming, and knight e4. This knight on e4 would be very annoying. So I do like black. I like, even though black sacrificed a pawn, I somehow like black's position. Even though this bishop is protecting this pawn, so this makes it very annoying for black to play. And suddenly I really like white position. Suddenly I really like white's position, and Mitrabha, who is Mitrabha? From India. Mitrabha Guha, okay, I have never heard of him, but he seems to be playing extremely well today, as he's in the fifth place right now. Your heart sung in the Arctic Ocean. When will you become GM? Takes a lot of time to become GM. How big is the Slovenian chess scene? Well, I am the one that's promoting chess the most in Slovenia, and we're currently just trying to like invite my players, but we have like 10, a bit more than 10 grandmasters. Of them, like 5 are active. Okay, what's going on here? Wow, well, black blundered the rook. But after this, black is getting back the bishop. there's gonna be there's gonna be some checks. Yeah, white is just winning. White is just winning. There's no checkmate tricks here. This pawn is just getting to a queen and it's GG. GG. Oh, he's a GM now. Okay, I didn't know. I didn't know. You guys know more about the Indian scene. But white is definitely winning this game. There's zero doubt that white is definitely winning this game. Let's stay till the end. Mitra have beat Magnus twice in Blitz. Wow, that's impressive. Slovenian hype, even though you're from Slovakia. We know, we support Slovakia as well. Okay, here's the finally the bishop goes, and now we see the checkmate, and boom, Mitrabha won this game. Who should we follow now? Let's watch Bortnik. Let's watch Bortnik. Most Slovenian politicians do not know the rules of chess. Maybe. I never asked them. Okay, guys, I'm gonna get some water because, you know, I have to speak a bit more and I need my vocals to work. So, guys, enjoy this game and we'll be back soon. What's Zhigalko's channel called? Don't know, but go check it out. Hello guys! Push the pawn! Chair stream! Where's the Lichess song? Very good question. Let's put the Lichess song. You guys missed it, didn't you? You guys missed the Lichess song. Wait, I'm gonna go for Lichess remix. Yeah, here we go. Here's the Lichess song. There was an Indian GM called Anand and I think who did commentary. he was the world champion as well. Take two bottles. No, I just took one. Hello, hello. Tier 1, 2 and 3 have different costs. I am. Yes, definitely. Russian water, yeah, we drink Russian water, we speak in Russian. No, I can speak some Russian words, but I cannot really speak that. Well, Rebecca Harris now in the fourth place. Let's go watch Rebecca Harris. Am I from the same country as Agat Mator? So Agat Mator is from Croatia, which is on the border of Slovenia. Not the same country, no. We want to make fun of the Lichess remix. Yes, let's go. Go. Dana Ljana. No, no, guys. This is water from the tap. You know, in Slovenia, water is drinkable because we are a very clean country. So I went to kitchen, opened the tap, did this and put water under the tap. This is how it works. How is hospital called in Russian? Ooh, I don't think I know that. I don't think I know that. Solaj dobro. It's not the same country, thought Eastern Europe is just one country. Yeah, we used to be Yugoslavia. Ooh, Black won this game, we missed this game, okay. Used to be Yugoslavia, used to be one country, and now it's not. Okay, guys, Night King still in the first place, playing Rebecca Harris right now. Ooh, what is this beautiful knight doing on g4? Oh, I love this knight so much. If only I could put my queen here. Oh, wait, I can. Oh, no, he didn't go for it, damn it. Oh, come on. Come on, check. Ah, no, he cannot go here because knight f3. He sacrificed the rook because of this. Because, okay, let's see what did Bortnik calculate here. I guess this was knight e3. But then, no, he has to play this, I guess. I guess this was what he calculated. Yes, I was right. Wait, what? Ah, he miscalculated because after this he loses his queen. Ah, so Bortnik miscalculated. Yeah, I also thought 95, but it's not so true. It's not so true. And Black resigned. Okay, so he sacrificed the rook because he thought he has 95, but actually he has this, and then after this, this has to move the king and he loses the queen. That's terrible blunder. Okay, I'm a chess gym at being eco-friendly. Thank you. Yes, Gigaako is streaming on YouTube, but in Russian. If you want to hear Russian, go to this channel. No, his channel, not my channel. His channel. If you want to hear English, stay on this channel. Anyway, we're Russian friendly. Okay, let's watch Michael. Mikhail, don't mess with the back. Ever been to California? No, never been to USA at all. This is how most bottled water company operates as well. Most such companies are scams. Yeah, I believe you, Roy. I do believe you. Laura, do you have a Twitch channel? I do have a Twitch channel. It's called Chiquitas. That's some 100 ill overthink. Yeah, that's definitely big overthink. Timmy should learn to speak Russian. I agree, I agree. Okay, so this was won by what? Mitrabha on fire. Mitrabha is now on fourth place on fire, and he could be competing for top three as well. Very, very good. Should we check if Gata Kamsky is still on tilt, guys? Let's check if Gata Kamsky is still on tilt. Is Gata Kamsky still on tilt? Okay, so Gata Kamsky quit the arena. Oh no. Oh no. Daniel was saying the Russian commentators bring forth better moves and then like, compared to American counterparts. Okay, depends, you know. I think hospital is called Krankenhaus. No, Krankenhaus is called in German. Krankenhaus. No, it's definitely, you know what, even I'm gonna check what's hospital in Russian. It's bolnish, it's what? It's bolnica, it's the same as Slovenian, bolnica. Same. Can I post your my Twitch in chat? I think there's a command streamer. Yeah, here you go. If you really want. Are you Lichess representative rooting for Magnus or Jan? The thing is that I'm rooting for good games. Okay, honestly, Knight King has 18 seconds, so it's gonna be hard for him. He'll probably lose this game. But honestly, I'm rooting for a better player, and so far Magnus has shown to be a better player. And in this match, I think, like, we deserve, for world champion, we deserve the best player, not just on this tournament, but the best player who plays the best chess in the whole year overall, right? And comparing Jan or Magnus to who plays the best chess in the whole year overall, I would say Magnus is a better player, and that's the reason I would be cheering for Magnus. If Magnus was, for example, playing Alireza in this match, I might be cheering for Alireza. I hope that's understandable. Magnus all day, okay. Yeah, Jan Kamsky made a hiss in. What is this song? Oh, we're still on the Asia's playlist. We're still on the Asia's playlist. Okay, we go back to Lichess Remix. Okay, this has been... wait. White has been flagged. White has been flagged by the 12 digits. That's a lovely digit. Okay, Dropstone now back on the first place. So let's go look at the current leader of the tournament. Do you feel the chess scene is welcoming to women? Yeah, I don't think it's unwelcoming at all. I think it's more welcoming than not. Do I think Alireza is stronger than Magnus? No, not yet. But maybe in a few years? Maybe. He has to go now, knight g7. If he went to the bishop, he would be lost due to queen e8. Or no, not... Yeah, queen e8, yeah. Yeah, Magnus is playing the best chess for 12 years. And yeah, that's the fact. So he deserves to be the world champion, yeah? Yeah, he has all the qualities for a world champion. So people who are cheering for Jan are not really thinking about who plays better chess, but like who they like more as a person, I guess, something like that. Ooh, black blunder, the checkmate. Ooh, what a blunder here, checkmate in one. This didn't have to happen. Black could play any move here. For example, this, and if white took this, would be taken with a check, so this would not be over. Do you think you're stronger than Shiro? Fun fact, I drew Shiro. Fun fact about that. I'm not stronger than Shiro, no. How did I learn to speak English so well? Well, actually, chess. When I went to chess tournaments, I was forced to speak in English to talk to other chess players, for example, analyze the games. And actually chess and playing on chess tournaments taught me to speak English that well. You would enjoy seeing Magnus in the candidate. Yeah, that would be funny, but I don't think he deserves to lose the title. You drew a GM in the simul. Bravo, that's very good. Okay, who should we watch? Rebecca Harris went for a break to get some water, I guess, in between. But I guess everybody would like to watch Rebecca Harris right now. You know? Let's watch Rebecca Harris. Ooh, wow! What's this opening? Oh, g4, nice. Okay, nice. Ooh, nice. Is this already lost for black? I think this is already lost for black. If we turn on Stockfish right now, I think it would show plus six. Chess players have only taught you words you cannot repeat. Yeah. You drew Shiro or you drew against Shiro? I drew against Shiro. I drew against Shiro, yeah. Okay, so King f7, white has how many pawns up? Ooh, white is 2 pawns up. Huge. White is definitely winning. Is it easy? I don't know, but white is definitely winning. Rebecca Harris is definitely winning against the very talented Mitra Pha. One other pawn. Black only has now 2 pawns against white's 5 pawns. So this is not really an amazing. Okay, now we're gonna go back to some blue music. Well, does anyone know what Daniel's called Rebecca Harris? I think, yeah, okay, so we realize it's actually a character from a TV show. It's not a politician, which for some reason I heard from somewhere, but it's a character from a TV show, I guess, which he really liked. And he decided to name his Lichess account. Knight c6 is a very strong move. The idea is this, or to take on d4. Why did not take on d4, though? I don't know. Again, maybe he's tired. Maybe it's bad. Who knows? Hello, Mr. Kosha! How did your game go today? How did your game go? Yeah, so this is the reason. Okay, so I love these pawns. Oh, these pawns are so nice. This is, for me, as a d4 player, an ideal pawn structure. This is what white wants to achieve. d5 pawn, black cannot take it. You know, it's just amazing. You lost, oh. It's okay, Mr. Kosha, it happens, it happens. You know, there's always supposed to be a bad game in the tournament. Okay, so he didn't decide to take on d5, which is maybe slightly surprising, but also, I think that was a slight blunder from Naroditsky to allow knight to d5. He was just thinking he can never take, but it's not true. He should still be careful. But he's still continuing the attack. The queen might be coming to g3, but white will have to look out for this queen g2 in the future. So after this knight h5. And now, okay, black cannot go rook g6 yet because of this check, but this is why king h8 was played. Now this is a huge threat. Knight h4 now played for the reason to stop this. Oh, I think this was, yeah. Now he cannot go back because then this would happen. This black is just pushing. Black, however, has only 17 seconds. So if white can save himself he saved himself from the last position, and now he can flag. Naroditsky can now flag Bortnik. Let's see if he will manage. 5 hour battle. You got really unlucky. It's okay. Just keep going. You can do it. you had a nice side blunder. Okay, now definitely Rebecca Harris is flagging him. His opponent. This if Rebecca Harris is not winning this today, yeah. This was a very nice dirty flag. I mean, Dania is perfect at dirty flagging, especially when his opponent is so down on time. We only have 24 minutes to go. No, let me drink some water. For Bortnik. Actually, poor Bortnik is not so poor because he's currently on the third place. But okay, him and Naroditsky are competing for the third place. Actually, battle for the third and second and even first place is extremely open. Nothing is decided yet. The drop stone is not on fire. Mikola is not on fire. Bortnik is not on fire. Rebecca Harris and Zaun are the only one who are on fire, so let's keep with Rebecca Harris, because if he wins this game, he could be jumping to number one spot, or at least number two spot. Tanya is your second favorite GM, who's the first? Maybe only Andrew Tang is better at dirty flagging. Yeah, I agree. What if Daniel suddenly plays the Bone Cloud? We'll see. But I think because he's fighting for the first place, he will not do it. Ah, Magnus, of course. Okay. Does Fabio play on Lichess? I have never seen Fabio play on Lichess. I've never seen Fabio play online chess. for that fact. Sunway is even tougher. Actually, Mr. Kosha, the tournament you're playing, I would say, is even tougher than Sieges. Because it's above 2000. And it's very tough. And there are a lot of talented players who are underrated, especially Indian players. So, I was debating to play this tournament exactly for this reason, and then when something else came up, I immediately decided to take the other chance, because it would be very hard to win rating on this tournament. Ah, Fabi had an account called Bomb? Grenade, okay. I didn't know that. That's a fun fact. So this game should be pretty much equal, right? Takes, and we're in this equal endgame. Black slightly better, of course. Now black has to move the bishop, or first give a check and then move the bishop. I think first you give a check, forcing the king to move, then you move the bishop here, or something like that. But I don't think Dania is winning. I don't think Dania is winning this game. Oh no, I'm out of battery. I might be losing one light. Okay, it's fine. It's only 20 minutes left. I can live without one light. I'm playing chess for 13 years. Do you know Garcia Martin Marta? I know her. Yeah, she's my age. Free pawn? What? Free pawn? There was a free pawn? Takes. Yes, this. Okay. Ah, yeah. No, this is... Now, was this agreed a draw? Yeah, this was agreed a draw. Of course, this position was a draw, so they just agreed. Which chess club do you belong to at the moment? Chess club Ljubljana. And I am from Spain, yeah. This game is awesome. Yeah, this game was interesting. But they decided to call it a day and just agree for a draw. They didn't want to play for dirty flag because they were both equal on time. Okay, look at these interesting pawns. Hung the queen. Wait, who hung the queen? Ah, no. Nothing. No one hung the queen, I guess. Yet. Okay, Dania again. Look at this. Playing for h4 h5. Ah, by the way, with this draw, Dania is put to 5th place and lost the fire. Dropstone, however, is back on fire, so Dropstone now looking to win the arena with 110 points. If we go back to the game, h4 g3 stabilizes the pawns, very lovely, saying black not to... I hate this, I have to say. I would here sacrifice the pawn, and look at this diagonal. Just go e3 or something. Look, this diagonal is killing. I think black should be somehow playing for the win. I think this is very good resource that Dania found. But look at this. This is terrible. King is still open. Bishop f7 was checkmate. Who is Dropstone? He's from Russia. Paravyan, David Paravyan. 10 people within 10 points. Yeah. It's very entertaining. It's a very entertaining tournament. What's my favorite Russian female player? Goryachkina. I've been commentating for 2 hours and 40 minutes. You're not... I'm... Lichess streamer title. I think you have to apply for a streamer title. And you don't have to be a candidate master to be a streamer. You can have any title or no title to be a streamer. You just have to apply to be a streamer, and then Lichess has to confirm you. When did you apply? If you applied one hour ago, it's not how fast it works. You know, it takes some days to be accepted. No wonder why you're so thirsty. Yeah, I am. My lips are very dry. It's like a desert here. Normal plays, person plays e4, good chess players play d4. Also, Naroditsky has 30 seconds, so black did not manage to take advantage of this weak king. However, anything can still happen. White is lucky that he has this bishop to cover the squares in a way. And okay, if white allows this rook down there, it's very dangerous, but he will not do that. And of course, this was checkmate threat. Okay, I lost one light, it's fine, we have 17 minutes to go. I played Goryachkina only in online. No, actually I played Goryachkina in classical chess this year. White won. Ah, okay. Because after this, and the pawn endgame is winning. Okay, so Rebecca Harris won. And he's now in fourth place. Knight King is third place. Michael is second and Dropstone is first. Let's go check on the leader. Dropstone is leading, his Paravian from Russia. Hikaru doesn't play on Lichess, he only plays on chess.com. Dark mode on, exactly. Now we're in the dark. We only have the light behind me. Yeah, he's contractually obligated to play just on chess.com. Which is another good thing about being a Lichess streamer. You can just like go wherever you want. But of course preferably on Lichess. Queen g4. I don't really understand this position. Honestly, I prefer to be black, even though rook is on h3 and there could be some checkmate threats. I just know that these moves are not useful if black knows how to take advantage of them. For example, the next move might be knight b4, threatening knight c2. Yes, now definitely this should be the move, threatening knight c2. Basically already asking white, how do you protect that? Do you play knight a3? Well, what will knight on a3 do? It's terrible there. And then maybe just some queen e8, something like this could happen. Actually, no, I don't think d5 or d6. Actually, queen e8! I feel so happy. I played like a grandmaster who's leading the titled arena. And because now bishop f6 or d6 is actually a very strong idea. You see the ghost again. Ooh. The power of open source. My opening choice was to play the slaw. She played the queen gambit, and I answered with the slaw defense. She's a very strong player. Honestly, I thought she was not playing some good moves when I played her. I was like, what's the point? What are you doing? You're supposed to be strong. No, but actually she was playing the best stockfish moves, just because I'm not used to like playing against stockfish. I was like, what? That doesn't make sense. But of course she played very good chess. You're already GM. Thank you. Who's walking around the background? You guys. Guys, stop trolling me. I lost in the classical game. I did lose in the classical game. I fought well, but of course she was very strong. Ooh, bishop f6. That what a move. Takes. So after queen f7, we would see, I guess, something like that. I honestly don't think this works. Yeah, just queen f7. I think black is winning. Black is actually is winning. After you take, if the queen moves, white, black can just play this and threaten checkmate. So you have to exchange and now black is just a piece up. Black is winning. So Dropstone is supposed to be winning another game, which means he's 1 point, actually 3 points, 3 points, 4 points, 5 points closer to winning the tournament. It's the ghost you saw before. Oh my god, stop trolling me with the ghosts. It's not nice. Did your mother never teach you not to troll people with ghosts? Okay, now you take. No? GG. No, this is GG. White can just resign. White can resign, definitely. Black could just also take this if he wanted to. He doesn't have to. No, he takes him. Yeah, GG. Dropstone now won, and which brings him on 120 points, which is 11 points, sorry, in front of the second place, who is Alexander Bortnik. So first place is already almost decided. 12 minutes left to go. Who's GG? Do you believe in ghosts? Depends on the moment. When you guys start trolling me like that, I will start believing. GG means GG, good game. If that's what you mean. Oh, I almost clicked join the tournament. No, guys, now it's not the time to join the tournament. Actually, Bortnik just lost the game and Michael is also losing the game. So they might be losing the second and third spots. Let's check Rebecca Harris. Rebecca Harris just went to the number three spot. So let's check if Rebecca Harris can take number two or three spot. When the ghost will attack her from behind, she'll understand that we were. God, stop, it's not funny. Okay, Rebecca Harris berserking against his opponent. Yes, still second place is still open for grabs, and actually Naroditsky can, with a win, be looking for number two spot, absolutely. Who will win the World Championship? I cannot predict the future. Whoa, Black just blundered the piece in one. Easy win, this will be an easy win for Rebecca Harris. I don't know who will win. Who are you cheering for is the question. Next stop working, no more power for Slovenia. Yeah, we lost the power. Yes, Rebecca Harris still on the third place. No, Rebecca Harris now on number two. He won the game and he's now on number two spot. Dropstone with first place. Rebecca Harris number second and third place still up for grabs. Let's follow Rebecca Harris. Maybe he's gonna be going for the first place. In 10 minutes, anything can happen. Did he go for the French? Oh no, it was not the French. Okay, it was the King's Gambit. The King's Gambit appeared on the board. And let's watch the entertaining games. Magnus takes it. That's what most people think. The ghost wants to do commentary as well. She has the fire team. Now you know who's emptying the bottle, the ghost is thirsty. Yes, that's exactly what's happening. Okay, let me follow the game. Who's better? Black. Black is the one attacking the king, but if white stops the attack, yeah, like this. This is just equal. This is just equal, even though the pawn just dropped, which means black is better. Black is better. How do they calculate so fast? They don't calculate, they mostly rely on intuition. they calculate concrete things like tactics. For example, they calculate this, the opponent cannot go here because I win the piece. So he has to go here, and then I take here and I win piece. But mostly it's also intuition. So Rebecca Harris now won another game, which means he is 3 points away from being number one. Let's check Dropstone. If Dropstone loses, Rebecca Harris will be winning. Dropstone has to win to keep the first place. So let's stay here. Let's stay here. This is now most entertaining game. Why did he not take? I don't know. But if Dropstone doesn't win, Rebecca Harris will be playing for the first place. Yeah, it's impossible to calculate. Okay, Dropstone won, which is very important for the standings, because Rebecca Harris now has a very tough job of catching the first place. Actually, first place is still up for grabs. If Rebecca Harris actually wins this game, he's gonna be 2 points away, so still very, very, very close. This game doesn't look like winning though, however, with Daniel's flagging skills, anything can happen. I just don't know. If I was white, I don't know how I would win this. I have no clue. I would have no clue. Yeah, Dropstone versus Daniel would be fun. Very fun now. Yeah, Hatrox. Yeah, very funny. We consider that as well. You want to see Harris Dropstone? Yeah, me too, me too. But the thing is that all the pawns are on white cards. Ooh, this is a beautiful pass pawn. Oh, that's so lovely. I think white is winning because this pass pawn is just crushing. Oh, he even resigned. Chameleon even resigned. Guys, this is crazy. Rebecca Harris now 122 while Dropstone 124 points. However, Dropstone is currently playing against Mikolai. So Michael, and let's see what will happen here. This could also be a decisive game, one of the decisive games. White is definitely having a good position, but actually black is having a very good position as well. So it's equal. Good evening, good evening. Rebecca Harris is now black. Now we will be going between two games because these two games are gonna be deciding the first place. Rebecca Harris still playing for the first place. Even though I have to say Heisenberg is playing very well. Yes, this is the idea, but also, oh, Naroditsky berserked while Heisenberg didn't. Which might be a mistake. Okay, let's go back to Dropstone. Dropstone has not really improved that much. Is it winning? No. It's still equal, I guess. It's still equal. That's all I can say. I cannot say more. There are not a lot of tricks that white can use in this position. Yes, he can try to go here, but the king is active. Okay, let's go back to Rebecca Harris. Wait, what happened? What happened? Rebecca Harris' previous game drew, and now is Rebecca Harris is now on the first place, but Rebecca Harris lost the fire, which means if Dropstone wins this game, he will most likely be the winner because he's on fire. So if Dropstone wins this game, he is 90% the winner of this tournament. FM finishing number 10. Also, if I'm correct, there was a national master in between, but okay, not anymore. Yeah, Rebecca Harris already in the new game, and honestly looks pretty good for Dania. Let's go. Dropstone is now the decisive game. Let's see Dropstone. 4 minutes to go, 4 minutes. Your elo is 1300s in Lichess. What opening should you learn to play? You know, decide whichever one. Wow, Dropstone will be, could be winning this. He could be winning this. Decide whichever opening you want. Like, you can play the Peart, you can play the French, you can play the Scandinavian. You should definitely decide something simple, not go directly for the Sicilian, because Sicilian, there's a lot of theory. This, like, pick something simple and learn like 10 moves of theory. Okay, Dropstone could be winning this. And if he does, well, this is not really tricky. And if he does, he will be definitely winning. He definitely will be winning. Or will he? Actually, it's not so clear even. This game can still last for a long time. Thoughts on the Petrov? It's equal. It's boring. It's boring, that's what I can say. Okay, so this game will be going on. Let's check on Rebecca Harris in between. Rebecca Harris is winning. He is winning, which actually means... Yeah, it's over. He has to play one more game. If Rebecca Harris wins the next game, he's the winner. Dropstone has to win, but he's slow because he's not berserking, which is very important. He should be berserking. He should be berserking if he wants to win this tournament. Let's go, Rebecca Harris. Rebecca Harris playing Hitter. Hitter, GM from where? India. So Rebecca Harris berserking, and if he wins this game, he's the winner. Is the winner of the tournament. He's currently number one. But also Dropstone is winning. Dropstone is winning. He has 10 seconds though. He has to be fast. Has to be fast. Has to be fast. 8-7. Yeah, rook g8 and queen. Okay. Okay, there were some weird moves. Okay, so he won. Dropstone did win the game. Sorry, I wanted to go here. Yeah. Dropstone won the game. Okay, where does that bring us? That brings us to Dropstone currently leading. So now Dropstone, if he wants to win, he has to berserk. However, if Naroditsky wins, before it's over, which might not be the case, he will win the tournament. You live near India? Really? Where do you live? So Rebecca Harris definitely should not lose. If he loses, he will not win the tournament. If he wins this, and if Dropstone doesn't win this in the next minute, Naroditsky will be winning. This doesn't look nice. This does not look nice. Even if he went here, this was lost because of this, and taking the queen. So he's forced to go for it. So this is very, very unclear now who's actually winning. I think white should be doing perfectly fine in this position. Okay, 40 seconds to go. 40 seconds to go. Mr. Titanic, it's practice. It's practice. Danny is losing. Oh god, Danny is also losing. Oh wow. Danny is losing, which means that Dropstone he drew. Which means Dropstone is the winner. Dropstone is the winner of the tournament if Dania doesn't win. And Dania did not win, so Dropstone is the winner of the tournament. That was actually very close. Now it's time for the Lichess song, you know? Now it's time to go back to the Lichess song. Okay, so this was actually a very entertaining ending. Dropstone won. It was not very clear. Naroditsky even beat him 5 minutes before the end of the tournament. And now Dropstone first, This is Grandmaster Paravian from Russia. Congratulations, Rebecca Harris, Naroditsky on the second place. He was so close to getting the first place. And on the third place, which was open for grabs to everyone, got Alexander Bortnik. And fourth place, Zavan. You know what, I'm just gonna show you so I don't speak too much. Some anvil for the end. Zavan, fourth place, fifth place, Mitrabha, very strong player. Blue Bomb, sixth place, Michael, seventh place, who was leading at the beginning. Chameleon, we didn't see him much, but he came very close at the end. Heisenberg and Hitter as well. Very, very interesting, very exciting games in the end. It was so close between first and second place. Also, third place was very open, but we decided to follow for the first place. What's the price? First place is $500, second place is $250, fourth place is $125, fourth is $75, and fifth place $50. Thank you, Quick Josh, for giving 5 subs to Lichess. Thank you very, 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 very much. That's so nice of you. Thank you for supporting the channel. And hope you enjoyed the commentary. Hope you enjoyed the games. I do have to say, I really enjoyed the commentary, especially at the end. Because the games were very, very important and deciding. During the tournament, it was really hard to find entertaining games. But we pulled through, guys. We pulled through. Do you agree? It was not so bad, hopefully. We learned some accents. We improved some French and some Russian. We learned the hospital in Russian is Bolnica. Oh, thank you, Quick Josh. Thank you. You see the ghost again? Okay, so, guys, you know what's gonna happen now? I'm gonna finish the stream, we're gonna raid someone, and I'm gonna go talk to that ghost. You're from Bangladesh, if I remember, which I know that country. I definitely heard of Bangladesh. We learned a lot about it in geography class, believe it or not. So yes, thank you very much. The ghost was a bit scary. Guys, stop with the ghost. Yes, so like I said, we will now be raiding somebody. Marichess, definitely drop her a follow or a sub. She's a lovely, lovely girl, lovely streamer, lovely player. Yes, so I will go talk to the ghost and you guys go talk to Marichess. Hopefully see you soon, guys. Enjoy your evening or day or night, wherever you are. And thank you so much for watching. Bye!
Lichess.